जी, द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू एन एक्सियल लाइन, और वी कैन से एंड ऑन पोजिशन. द अदर नेम ऑफ दिस थ्योरम इज एंड ऑन पोजिशन, दिस डेरिवेशन. सो हियर इज अ डाइपोल हैविंग टू चार्जेस प्लस क्यू एंड माइनस क्यू. दे आर सेपरेटेड बाई सर्टन डिस्टेंस, दैट इज 2a. फ्रॉम द सेंटर वी कैन से ए एंड ए. देर इज वन मोर पॉइंट वेयर वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सेंटर टू दिस पॉइंट इज वी कैन से आर, राइट. सो नाउ स्टार्ट अवर न्यू टॉपिक, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू एन एक्सियल लाइन. द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू अ पॉइंट पी एट अ डिस्टेंस आर फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ द डाइपोल, दैट इज वी कैन से ई एक्सियल. E axial, clear? And the value of E axial is equal to E B minus E A, right? E B minus E A. This is the value of E axial. If E B is larger, then this quantity is positive. If E B is smaller, then this quantity will be negative. Clear? Now, the value of E B, electric field at point A. Electric field due to this point A, that is negative charge, right? Or we can use this symbol also, E minus Q, right? From this point to this point, the electric field due to this charge at this point, it is equivalent to, as we know, the formula of electric field is KQ by R square, KQ by the distance between these two points are R square. R is, that is equal to separation between these two points, that is R and plus A the whole square. Clear? Equate this as equation number 1. This field is due to this charge, that is for negative charge. Similarly, electric field for positive charge E plus Q, we can write E is equal to K Q upon the distance between positive charge and this electric field due to this point at this point is equal to KQ upon separation the square. Separation between these two points are, that is R minus this distance, that is equal to R minus A the whole square. Equate this as equation number 2. Put these two values in this equation, we can say equation star. Put 1 and 2 in star equation. Put 1 and 2 in star equation. So we get E axial equals to KQ, B is R minus A the whole square upon R minus A the whole square minus K Q upon R plus A the whole square. Why we subtract this term? Because as we know, this is the point where we have to calculate the electric field. This is the point where we have to find the electric field. So this point we can say is called axial point. This point we can say this is the axial point. And these two electric field directions are equal and opposite. So net field will be, that is equivalent to EB minus EA, right? EB minus EA. So we subtract the term EB minus EA and we get, taking KQ as common, 1 upon R plus A the whole square minus 1 upon R minus A the whole square minus 1 upon R plus A the whole square, right? This is minus, right? And now we know KQ 1 upon R minus A the whole square, R plus A the whole square taking as LCM. So we get R plus A the whole square minus R minus A the whole square, right? So we know A plus B the whole square, that is A square plus B square plus 2AB, and A minus B the whole square, A square plus B square minus 2AB. So plus terms will become negative and they will cancel out. So we are left with only E axial, it is equivalent to 4 A R आउटसाइड के क्यू डिवाइड बाय आर स्केयर माइनस ए स्केयर का होल स्केयर, राइट। सो एज वी नो के इज इक्वल टू क्यू इंटू टू ए इंटू टू आर, वी कैन राइट दिस इक्वेशन एज टू ए एंड टू आर बिकॉज देर इज फोर, वी कैन बाइफ्लेट दिस फोर इंटू टू ए एंड टू आर डिवाइड बाई आर स्केयर माइनस ए स्केयर का होल स्केयर। सो एज वी नो द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू इंटू टू ए, द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू इंटू टू ए इज पी इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल, राइट, देन के टू पी इंटू आर अपॉन आर स्केयर माइनस ए स्केयर द होल स्केयर, दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्सियल लाइन, राइट स्टूडेंट। नाउ इफ वी टेक द स्पेशल केस, इफ वी टेक द स्पेशल केस देन नाउ लुक एट दिस इक्वेशन, इफ वी कैन से दैट आर द वैल्यू ऑफ आर दिस आर इज मच लार्जर, वी कैन सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस पॉइंट पी एट अ वेरी लार्ज डिस्टेंस, वी कैन से एट हेयर, सो दिस डिस्टेंस वी कैन से दिस डिस्टेंस ए विल बिकम वेरी वेरी स्मॉल, वी कैन से वेन आर इज मच ग्रेटर देन ए, वेन आर इज मच ग्रेटर देन ए द सेपरेशन बिटवीन दिस फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ द डाइपोल टू दिस पॉइंट इज वेरी वेरी लार्ज एज कंपेयर टू दिस डिस्टेंस, देन आर स्केयर माइनस ए स्केयर वी कैन से थाउजेंड माइनस वन अप्रोच और पॉइंट वन, थाउजेंड माइनस पॉइंट वन इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली इक्वल टू थाउजेंड, राइट। सो दिस इक्वेशन विल बिकम लाइक दिस, नाउ द न्यू इक्वेशन ऑफ ई एक्सियल वे यू हैव लर्नड इज के टू पी आर अपॉन आर द पावर फोर, सो दिस आर एंड दिस आर विल कैंसल आउट, वी आर लेफ्ट विद ओनली टू के पी अपॉन आर द क्यू, राइट। सो स्टूडेंट दिस इज ऑल अबाउट इन एक्सियल लाइन, नाउ मूव ऑन टू इक्वेटोरियल लाइन। नाउ द नेक्स्ट टर्म इज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू एन इक्वेटोरियल लाइन और वी कैन से ब्रॉडकास्ट ब्रॉड साइड ऑन पोजिशन, ठीक है, ब्रॉड साइड ऑन पोजिशन, ब्रॉड साइड्स ऑन पोजिशन, राइट, दिस इज अनदर नेम ऑफ इक्वेटोरियल लाइन। इक्वेटोरियल मीन्स इक्वली डिविजन इज देयर, इक्वली डिविजन इज देयर, लाइक दिस दिस परपेंडिकुलर बाई सेक्टर, दिस परपेंडिकुलर बाई सेक्टर, कट दिस टू टाइपल्स इन अ इक्वल पार्ट, राइट। So let us assume this distance is 2a, we can say a and a from the center O, right. If this is the perpendicular distance where we have to find the, this is the point where we have to find the value of electric field, like in previous case we take the center from this point to the axis where we have to find the value of electric field P. Similarly, now again we take the point P from the center O and take the distance r, like in the previous case we take the distance r where we have to find the electric field, got it na? So to calculate the value of electric field at this point due to these two charges we can say minus q and plus q charges, right. Now look at the equation, this is negative charge, negative charge, negative charge for this point, negative means electric field arrow will be in the inward direction towards this charge, right. So we can write this as E minus electric field due to a negative charge, right. If this is the angle theta, this is the angle theta, and similarly for positive charge electric field will be like this outward direction, right. So this positive direction is further divided into its rectangular component, two rectangular component, we can say if this is the this is angle theta, because here is again angle is theta, if this is angle theta then if it is E positive resultant electric field, so this will become E positive cos theta and this will become E positive sine theta, right. If this is the negative sign then it will become E negative will become, this is angle theta, E negative of cos theta, and this will become E negative of sin theta, right? Now the value of electric field due to charge minus Q, right? Due to charge minus Q. So E of minus Q, it is equivalent to K Q by R square. What is the separation value? That is equal to R square plus A square ka whole square, right? Similarly, in terms of, I am taking this term in terms of magnitude, right? Similarly, electric field due to a negative charge, and similarly for a positive charge, it will become again E is equal to K cube on separation. Separation is from this point to this point is under root of R square plus A square. Equate this as equation number 1 and this as equation number 2, right? Again, electric field due to this charge is E is equal to K cube on separation, where we have to find the electric field is under root of R square plus A square, K cube on R square. Similarly for this, K cube on R square, right? Now these two components is further divided into its rectangular component, because it is a vector quantity. So these two components as E positive and E negative resolved into its rectangular component. What are the rectangular components? The rectangular components are, that is E plus cos theta, E plus sin theta, E minus cos theta, and E minus sin theta, right? Or we can see E minus Q. Got it, nah? Now you can see from these two equations, the value of the magnitude of E positive Q and E negative Q are same. So here in the diagram, if the magnitude of E positive and E negative are equal, both are sin theta, as the magnitude of E positive and E negative are equal, and both are equal and opposite in direction. Okay? So the effect of these two terms will cancel each other. So there is no effect. There will be no effect. But in this case, the magnitude of E plus and E minus are same, but both are in the same direction. These two terms are in the same direction. So they will add each other. So we can write this term as the magnitude of E plus sin theta and E minus sin theta are equal and opposite. So they will cancel each other. And we are left with only one component, that is E positive cos theta and E negative cos theta. So we can write equation for E equatorial, electric field equatorial, as E equatorial is equal to 2 times E positive or E negative of cos theta, because E positive cos theta plus E negative cos theta. E positive cos theta and E negative cos theta, magnitude of E positive and E negative are same. So we can directly write this as E 2 times E positive cos theta. Got it, na? So 2 times E positive cos theta means the value of E positive is K Q upon R square. And already we have calculated this value. E positive is K Q upon under root of R square plus A square. So we can write this equation here as K क्यूब अपॉन अंडर रूट ऑफ आर स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर का, अंडर रूट ऑफ आर स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर का होल स्क्वायर, करेक्ट दिस टर्म्स ऑल्सो, अंडर रूट ऑफ आर स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर का होल स्क्वायर. सो वी गेट आर स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर. एंड द फॉर्मूला फॉर कॉस थीटा, कॉस थीटा इज बेस्ड अपॉन हाइपोटेन्यूज, कॉस थीटा इज बेस्ड अपॉन हाइपोटेन्यूज. सो हियर इज अ कॉस थीटा, कॉस थीटा इज परपेंडिकुलर बेस एंड हाइपोटेन्यूज, परपेंडिकुलर बेस हाइपोटेन्यूज, दिस इज बेस एंड दिस इज हाइपोटेन्यूज. सो दिस इक्वेशन विल बिकम ए अपॉन अंडर रूट ऑफ आर स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर, गॉट इट ना, बेस अपॉन हाइपोटेन्यूज. सो वी गेट के क्यू इंटू टू ए अपॉन आर स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर द पावर वन एंड वन बाई टू, दिस विल बिकम थ्री बाई टू. सो वी गेट के क्यू इंटू टू ए इज पी अपॉन आर स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर का पावर इज थ्री बाई टू. एंड नाउ अगेन दिस इक्वेशन इज फॉर इक्वेटोरियल लाइन, इक्वेटोरियल लाइन इज अ फाइनल केस. नाउ अगेन स्पेशल केस, एस आर इज मच ग्रेटर देन ए, अगेन देन आर स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर अप्रोचेस टू आर स्क्वायर इज अ स्टैंडर्ड टर्म. सो द इक्वेशन ऑफ ई इक्वेटोरियल विल बिकम के पी अपॉन आर द क्यूब, गॉट इट. Now, sometime this question may be asked in the paper, like what is the relation between E axial and E equatorial? E axial is equal to dash time E equatorial. Now, you know E axial is equal to, what is the relation between E axial and E equatorial? Relation you have to find. So E axial is equal to 2 time Kp upon R cube. Similarly, for E equatorial, it is equal to Kp upon R cube. This is equation 1, this is equation 2. If we divide these two equations, E axial divided by E equatorial, E axial divided by E equatorial, we get Kp, Kp, R cube will cancel. Means it is equivalent to 2. Means E axial equal to 2 times E equatorial. Got it? This is the important result. Now students, sometimes examiner can be asked this type of questions also. Like what is the direction of electric field due to a dipole in case of axial and equatorial line? Right? So we have already done the equation, that is axial line, axial line. Now the resultant electric field is in the direction of B, electric field. We have right here, that is E axial is equal to EB minus EA. So we can write this equation as, it should be noted that the direction of electric field intensity on both side of dipole is parallel. It is parallel to the direction of electric field, right? If I asked in terms of vector, we can write this equation as k 2p upon r cube vector, right? But in case of equatorial, here the direction of electric field is, that is, this is the direction, right? This is the direction of dipole. Like in this case, this is the direction of dipole, negative to positive. Electric field and dipole's directions are same. But in this case, the dipole direction and the electric field direction, this is the resultant direction of electric field, resultant direction of electric field. Take E. And negative, positive, resultant direction of electric field. And the direction, both the directions are opposite. So in vector form, we can write this equation as, in vector form, we can write this equation as E vector is equal to negative of Kp upon R cube. Why it is negative? Because the direction of electric field and dipole are opposite to each other, Understand, na? So the next topic is electric field intensity due to a short dipole, or we can say at any point. So student, this is the axial line. This is the line of electric dipole. Electric dipole. Let us assume we have two charges, plus Q and minus Q. This is the central point. Okay. So this is the point where we have to find the electric field intensity. And this is not along the axis and perpendicular to the perpendicular bisector of these two dipoles. So it is placed in between these two points. That's why it is called at any point. Okay. So let us assume it makes an angle theta with this line, and we can say this is the direction of electric dipole moment P. This is the direction of electric dipole moment P. The direction of electric dipole moment is opposite to the direction of electric field. So negative Q and positive Q, and this is the direction of P. So resolve this P into its rectangular component. We can say this as P cos theta, and this component as P sin theta, right? This is the point where we have to calculate the electric field. So this distance is, we can say, R distance. Okay, this is the R distance. Let us assume at this point the electric field be E1, because of this P cos theta, there is an electric field produced E1, and because of this dipole P sin theta, there is an electric field produced, we can say, E2, and this is the resultant that is E at any point, right? E vector. So here is an angle alpha which is used to calculate the direction of electric field, right? So E1 is along the line, so we can write this as this is for E axial, because it is along the, it will behave like an axial line. And it is perpendicular to this line, so this will become E equatorial, behaves like an equatorial line. So we can write E1 as the magnitude of E1 as 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, that is K 2P upon R cube, because this is axial line, 2KP upon R cube. Now the value of P here is P cos theta. So we can write P cos theta. Instead of V, P, we write P cos theta. Similarly for E2. It will become K. Instead of 2P, we can write P upon R cube. Now in this case, the value of P is P sin theta, because it is perpendicular. P sin theta. So the net resultant E will be equivalent to, as we know the vector, E is equivalent to under root of E1 square plus E2 square. So this will become under root of KP upon R cube, taking as common. So we are left with 4 cos theta the whole square, and this is the whole square term, plus sin theta the whole square. So taking this term out, KP upon R cube, square out, cancel out, and it will become 4 times cos square theta, 2 cos theta the whole square, 4 times cos square theta plus sin square theta, right? So this equation will become KP upon R cube under root of 4 cos square theta, that is, we can write this फोर कॉस के थीटा इज थ्री कॉस के थीटा प्लस कॉस के थीटा प्लस साइंस के थीटा. गॉट इट? सो द इक्वेशन विल बिकम के पी अपॉन आर क्यूब अंडरूट ऑफ थ्री कॉस के थीटा प्लस कॉस के थीटा प्लस साइंस के थीटा इज वन. अंडरस्टैंड? नाउ इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ डायरेक्शन, सो I already told you that this alpha specifies the direction. So, if we want to find the value of direction, then tan of alpha, that is equal to tan of alpha, perpendicular. Perpendicular means E2 divided by perpendicular upon base, E1. The value of E2 is 2kp upon, sorry, kp upon r cube sin theta. Kp upon r cube into sin theta means kp upon r cube into sin theta multiplied by e1. The value of e1 is 2kp upon r cube into cos theta. So we can divide this term as 2kp cos theta upon r cube. So r cube and r cube, kp and kp will cancel out. So we are left with tan of alpha is equal to half of tan of theta, or we can say alpha is equal to tan inverse of 1 by 2 of tan theta. This is one of the most important result. Okay, now student, we have already find out the value of E at any point. So the value of E at any point is kp upon r cube under root of 3 cos square theta plus 1. How can we believe this is the finalist result? This is the good result. How can we believe? This result. So we can use some of the tactics here to prove this term also. Like, as we know, in case of axial line, we know for axial line this theta will be zero because this point lies on this axis. So we can place, what we can do, we can take this point P from here to this point, right? From here to this point. So for this, the equation theta will become 0. For axial line, theta will become 0. Got it, na? Theta will become 0 because this point P lies here. Okay, this theta will become 0. So E axial will become K P upon R cube under root of 3 cos 0. Cos 0 is 1. So 3 plus 1. So we get the result, that is 2. 4 means 2 kp upon r cube, which is the result of axial line, which is the result of axial line. Similarly for student, E equatorial. For E equatorial, the point P lies perpendicular to this point, right? So the angle formed by theta is 90 degree. So now E equatorial will become kp upon r cube under root of cos 90 is 0, 0 plus 1. So this is the final result, student, which is same as that of equatorial line. This is how we can check the equation also. Got it? This is a very simple result. Thank you, students.